Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. And this is the first time I'm showing my face here. In today's videos, I'm excited to bring you something new. Adobe Photoshop Mobile has just released a beta version for Android. And I got early access. Let's explore what features is offered so far.
Adobe Photoshop Mobile Beta for Android. In-depth review and feature comparison. In this video, we take a deep dive into the newly released Adobe Photoshop Mobile Beta for Android, now available on Google Play. While still in early access, this version already offers an impressive set of tools and a sleek user experience that promises a lot for Android users. Here's our complete breakdown. Minimalist and intuitive UI. The app introduces a clean, dark-themed interface that is modern, clutter-free, and optimized for touch interaction. Tools are logically arranged, and navigation feels intuitive even for first-time users. Adobe has clearly designed this version with simplicity and speed in mind, ideal for quick edits on the go. Essential layer functions. The Layer tab includes all the core functions. Add, duplicate, delete, and rearrange layers, toggle visibility, rename layers, basic blending modes like normal, multiply, screen. While it lacks advanced options such as layer masks or grouping present in the iOS version, it's still more than capable for most mobile editing tasks. Core editing tools, selection, retouch, and crop. You'll find a solid selection of essential tools. Selection tools, lasso, quick select, effective for basic object isolation. Retouch tools, spot healing, clone stamp, work smoothly for removing blemishes or unwanted details. Crop and resize, intuitive resizing with aspect ratio locking or custom sizes. While power users might miss features like refine edge or feather controls, the basics are well executed and reliable. AI-powered features and color adjustments. One of the highlights is the integration of Adobe's Generative Fill beta powered by Firefly. Remove or add elements using text prompts. Still in beta, but results are surprisingly accurate and natural. Other adjustment tools include hue and saturation, brightness and contrast, exposure, temperature, and more, with coming soon tags on advanced adjustments. Though it lacks adjustment layers like in desktop/iOS, the real-time sliders and results are quite responsive and precise. Compared to the iOS version, Photoshop Mobile Beta on Android offers a clean and responsive UI, though not as polished or optimized for stylus use like on iOS with Apple Pencil. The layer system on Android remains basic, lacking grouping or masking features. Editing tools cover the essentials but miss advanced options like liquify or refine edge. Generative fill works but is slower and still in beta, whereas iOS offers smoother results. Color adjustment tools are available on both, though iOS provides more precision. Performance on Android is good on flagship devices, but overall, iOS still delivers better optimization and consistency. This Android beta version of Photoshop Mobile is a strong starting point, smooth, intuitive, and powered by AI. It's ideal for casual users and mobile creatives who need powerful tools on the go. Try it now on Google Play and let us know what you think in the comments.